We're at North High School's Urban Field, where tonight the homecoming game features Sheboygan North against Green Bay Preble. Hello, everybody. Alongside the coach, Chris Wright, I'm Mike Martin. Chris, some late-breaking news, and I know you did all your prepping based on Coy Wanner being the starting quarterback for Preble. He's out with a broken hand.
Yeah, you just surprised me with that. I don't know if that changes the game or anything like that. One thing Preble does a little bit is struggle on the offensive end, but they might really struggle tonight without their leading the quarterback of the offense.
Well, I was looking at these stats. He's 49 for 146 attempts. Maybe they do need a different thrower back there.
Well, I was looking at the thing there. Preble is ninth in offense in the league, and Sheboygan North is 10th, so both teams obviously, offense is not their strength, and not having their quarterback back there might be a difference. The problem for Sheboygan North, though, is they can't stop anybody, and, if it's which quarterback or not, it may not make the difference. Can you stop the run and, do those kind of things? It might be a little easier. It's been a couple of rough games for North the last couple of weeks, playing Bayport and DePere. Preble's just 3-3, so maybe this is one they can get.
Now looking at the rushing stats, Wanner was their leading rusher, and he's only averaging a little over 2 yards a carry. Their other back, Hughes, I believe his name is averaging 6.1, but he doesn't have a whole lot of carry, so you got to expect he'll be seeing the ball more tonight.
Yeah, I think that both teams are going to have to somehow find a running game. I know that North had a lot of balance too, but, just look at the weather. We've had all sorts of weather this year. We've never had a perfect night, and tonight we have wind. Just a brutal wind coming off the northeast. What a shock off the lake a little bit here. So it's going to be difficult for teams to pass. So, Sheboygan North and Preble are going to try to put it on the ground a little bit.
I was just looking around here. We got the band on one side and the pom-pom squad on the other. I think the pom-pom squad needs their pants on. It's pretty cold out here. Let's talk a little bit about North. Last week we saw a whole change in terms of how to run the ball for North. And that was Bailey Meyer. You think we'll see that again tonight?
I absolutely did like that way. And the reason I liked it last week is because it's quick decisions, quick hitters. Go to the quick hole. You don't really have the size to match up against a team like DePere and most of the teams that they're playing in the league. So I thought that was a really positive change. Getting Bailey to run with the football a little bit and getting some holes there. They basically didn't even use Keenan Gilbert at all in the entire game. I don't remember even seeing him. And so I thought that was a real positive thing. Another thing we've always said about this besides that is getting Bailey out of the pocket a little bit, give him a little more time to use his receivers like Spaulding and what's his name, Peter Green?
Isn't he the leading receiver on the team? Talking about the passing game, you mentioned the wind and how strong it is right now. That could play a little bit of havoc with North's strength on offense, and that is the passing game.
Yeah, they like to go deep to Peter Green, and teams have tried to put double and even triple coverage on him, but it seems like Peter always seems to get big hits, scores down the field and things like that. So I still go with it, the flow, especially if you're coming, from north to south. You definitely have the wind. We'll see if that does play a big factor, field position, with the wind.
We talked about Wanner being out for a Preble, their starting quarterback. One of the starters on both sides of the ball that's out tonight, as a matter of fact, for the rest of the season, is Ben Miller. I think they're going to miss him more on the defensive side than they will on the offensive side, and that's where North struggles, on defense.
Yeah, and I mentioned last week when he got hurt, he's kind of like a leader on the team, too. He's a nice kid, and he's fun to him, and he's great one-liner guy, and he's kind of somebody who's inspirational in the dugout.
in the dugout next spring.
In the huddle, he's kind of an inspirational leader, and you need kids like that. But he does play both sides of the ball. He sticks on defense, and of course played that little wing back or H-back or as they call it out of the backfield. So he definitely replaced, and we'll see who steps up for North.
Also, talking about the H-back position, he was a nice catcher, too. And he caught a few balls here and there, just enough to take the pressure off of Peter Green.
Yeah, and he's got good speed. Maybe Dylan Lindell will have to move into that spot, too. But then again, that wears on Dylan. Dylan's play safety. And, we've seen this year Dylan make way too many tackles from his safety position. So now you put him on the offensive end. And again, that wears and tears after, you're playing four solid quarters.
I think last week when Ben got hurt, they brought in a kid by the name of Phil, and he played back there. I believe his number was 47. you know, maybe I need to look to him to catch a few balls and, of course, do some blocking in the backfield.
Yeah, I think he split a little time with Dylan back there. And, you know, it's next man up, and you never want to see anybody get hurt. But, unfortunately, it seems like every season somebody gets hurt, and for North this year, it was Ben.
Yeah, well, we're going to step out. When we come back, we'll have the starting lineups and the kickoff for tonight's football game.
America's service members and veterans are strong, forged out of bravery, sacrifice, and duty. Sometimes reaching out for help can be the most challenging and worthwhile mission of all. When you recognize something isn't right, make the call to the Veterans Crisis Line or Military Crisis Line. Dial 1-800-273-8255 and press 1.
When you're behind the wheel, always watch for people walking and biking. It's Wisconsin law to give bikes at least 3 feet when passing. In Wisconsin, the laws are the same for bicyclists and motorists. So if you bike, ride with the traffic, and obey stop signs and lights. People ride bicycles to go places, get exercise, reduce pollution, save money, and have fun. Watch for people riding bikes when you're driving. Share and be aware. We're all responsible.
North. Bill Horsch going through the seniors for Sheboygan North. I'll run through those names for you because we caught it a little bit late. Bailey Meyer is a senior. Peter Green is a senior. Josh Fritz, number 15. Number 28, Jamil Amison is a senior. Tony Bolt, number 30 is a senior. Number 32, Jacob Sheshaw, also a senior. Hayden Herman, number 34. Calvin Lee, number 56. Israel Jasso, number 57. Dominic Andrews, number 61. and Cal Spaulding, number 87, are all seniors. And there you see the North Eye team heading off to the sideline, getting ready for the kickoff to start our football game tonight. Preble comes in with a 3-3 record. North is 1-5. Struggled the last couple of weeks. I'm not sure who won the toss. I did see the officials come over and get the captains, and then my attention was drawn away from seeing what happened with the flip. But we do have some number changes too, Chris. I'll maybe give you that. Lucas Bunting, who's number 7.
Yep, he's a spare.
24.
Yep.
Brandon Ware is number 70. I believe he was 67. Jacob Mean is now a tight end. He's number 80. That was that kid last week. We didn't know who it was. Evan Belvin is 74. And right below him, L.J. Werner is 84. Well, there's some number changes. Getting ready to do the kicking for the Hornets is Austin Lassay. And we have back deep for North, Lindau and Yerk.
No, I think it'd be Peter Green.
Green.
Yep.
And
I hate to say this, Marty, but those two guys have had the most kickoff returns of anybody in the league. You know why that is?
Don't tell me.
And we don't have any windows open today, Marty. We're just
going to keep everything closed.
With that north wind, that would be howling in here.
Kick carries deep and into the end zone. Not a surprise, the wind is blowing out of the north. Gilbert was the other return man along with number 5, Dylan Lindau. Green was not back there, Chris.
Oh, wow.
Myers checks in at quarterback.
Well, I think it's important, as you mentioned, Marty, to maybe get some first downs with the wind. Now they're against the wind.
Yeah.
See if they can somehow generate some positive yards, maybe with Bailey Meyer out of the backfield.
First and 10 north. And Meyer taking it off left end. Bounces off one tackler before he's hit at about the 28-yard line.
You know, and I'd almost use this. I know it sounds really strange, Marty, but I would almost use this like when you're ahead in a game. I would wait for the official to start signaling that you're running a delay of game because you want to hold the ball as long as possible, you know, against the wind. But, of course, they rush right up there. Just a different strategy.
I hear you. Get the clock run down this first quarter. Meyer taking it around the right end, slips by one tackler and gets it up over the 30-yard line. It'll be a first down for the Raiders, and a good start to the ball game for them.
Yep. I mentioned that the offense for Preble struggles in ninth, but they are third in the league in defense, Marty. So they are quite stout up there, and they've already played, you know, Bayport, Ashwaubenon, and De Pere.
I noticed in the points allowed, they gave up 127 points, but at this juncture of the season, that's not too bad.
Nope.
You got first and 10 for North, ball spotted on the 31-yard line.
And only a minute's gone off.
So. Lindau is the wide out on this side. We get a handoff to a running back, Herman, and he gets hit right at about the line of scrimmage. Not much there.
Herman kind of was flipping a little bit with Keenan Gilbert, and here you see the replay.
We'll give him a no gain on that.
Oh, and Herman took a shot there. He's not doing so good coming off, Marty.
That's not a good thing. You know, I don't see Green out there, Chris. I'm just wondering what happened. Meyer, second down, a little over 10. We'll give Hayden Herman a no gainer on that, and pickup of about 4 yards for Meyer. It's going to be third and about 6.
Well, I do see Peter here. He's right by the table. And he's all covered up in a jacket. And I don't think this is because he's hurt.
Yeah, and then you know there's something else going on because you don't keep your best receiver on the sidelines for no reason. Josh Fritz, among the three that are wide to the left, Lindau, the widest of the bunch, Meyer keeps it, but he gets hit just as he crosses the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard, and it's going to be fourth down.
See, and I just think they attacked too fast, Marty. They should have taken more time off the clock. There's only, you know, you ran, what, six plays and 9:14 here. Bailey Meyer comes in averaging 37-2. He's second in the league in punting, but even if you're second in the league in punting against this one, it's going to be tough. But it's going to be tough for the receiver, too.
Yeah, fourth down and about six. Kick is away, almost blocked, one right between the arms. And the ball is fumbled, and falling on top of it is Sheboygan North.
Hey, how about that for a call? It's going to be tough for that guy, too.
Watch his kick just barely gets through the arms. And the fumble, I believe falling on it was David Sonnentag. North is going to keep it, and they picked up about 30 yards of field position.
That's a good way to put it, Marty.
Make it first and 10, ball on the 40-yard line of Preble. Meyer takes the snap, takes it off left tackle, bounces off of one tackler. He's through another tackle, and he takes it down inside the 25-yard line. First and 10, North.
Well, and the key in that run is just student body left, basically, and just a quick, all you have to do is hold a quick block. You don't have to be long in there. And there's some big kids on the Preble side, as usual.
That was a 16-yard run, Chris. Ball spotted on the 24-yard line. It's first and 10, North. They're on the move. Got the first turnover of the game. The deep back is Herman. Preble blitzing. Herman gets through the line of scrimmage and gets it up to about the 20-yard line before he's stopped. Give him a gain of 4 at second and 6.
Well, I don't know if you can see on your monitors or your TVs at home, but Lewis Saldana is the nose guard, and he's going today at 6'3", 350 pounds, Marty. That's why we haven't seen any runs up the middle.
Yeah, really? Second down. Gilbert gets the handoff, and he just gets leveled. Holy cow, did you see that?
I
thought he was going to gain some yardage, and all of a sudden he just disappeared.
Well, let me tell you, like every week is the same.
Watch this. Watch little number 4. And right there he just disappears.
Yeah. But every time he gets hit, he pops right back up. That young man is quite courageous. Just a junior, 5'4", 125. We've talked about him before. He does have good speed.
Third down and 5, ball on the 19. Meyer rolling. He takes it, and he gets leveled at about the line of scrimmage. No gain there, and it's going to be fourth down.
Well, obviously they're going to go for it here. Got fourth and about, we'll call it 5?
Yep,
four or five.
Fourth and 5. No gain on that last run. Meyer's got 6 carries already for a little over 30 yards. He's had a nice night running the ball. Herman in the backfield, along with Peyton Thill, the H-back. Quick slant to Lindau is incomplete. Preble takes over on downs. That's a good pass for these type of conditions, Chris. You know, keep it short.
Yeah, I was just going to say that's a good idea on that slant. I was kind of surprised he overlet it into the wind like that. Well, they flipped the field, Marty.
Yeah, that's important.
Especially, you know, if you can hold Preble down a little bit here, you know, get the ball back, maybe you'll have the win then.
And Boxall at quarterback.
Oh,
and the
no.
running back gets through the line of scrimmage, and he's out in the open. He's down to the 40-yard line of North before he finally gets dragged down near the 30. Darion Hughes is that kid that we mentioned hadn't carried the ball a whole lot. He'll be carrying the load a little bit more tonight.
Yeah, the 6 foot, 190 pounder went right through the hole, and that just completely changes everything.
46 yard run, Chris. First and 10, Preble. Ball spotted on the 35. Hughes the deep back. And Boxall hands it off. This time it's to the other running back. This is Michael Rayner. And it's going to be another first down run. Chris, ball gets down to the 23-yard line. They are just ripping off chunks of yardage.
Well, two plays, 50 yards. They've had the ball for a haul of 18 seconds, Marty.
12-yard pickup on that play. Pitch out, Hughes. Nice tackle made out there by Herman.
Well, it started with the kickout block here to get rid of Yerk. And then it just opens. Yerk is there, but he just gets tossed down there like a sack of potatoes.
Second down and 7 for the Preble Hornets.
Tackle over here is Ryan Bosley. He's 257, 6'3".
Hughes again on the carry.
Missed tackle by
Bell. Actually, there were two missed tackles before he was finally dragged down. He was on a nice carry. Picks up about 5. It's going to be 3rd down and 2.
And Dylan Lindau has to come up again from his safety spot. I'll tell you that, Dylan Lindau, he's tough.
Third down and 2. The blocking back there is Carlos Ponce. He's been helping clear the way. He's in motion right now. Look at that big guy. Right up the middle. He was hit and pushed back. And I don't think he got the first down, Chris.
Good thrust by the north line. Could be short, according to the official.
Yeah, give him 1 yard. It's going to be 4th and 1.
Nice job. Preble going to go for it here.
Yeah, they might as well.
Timeout north. Short of personnel.
Yeah. Coming off the field, Chris, was Norris Clayton Bell. The interior linemen for North on this defense are Nathan Heitzman, number 54. Evan Belvin, number 74. L.J. Werner, 84. And Cam Bell, number 44.
Yep. Cam and Clayton brothers, and their brother Carson played a couple years ago, played 3 years on the varsity.
Good Catholic family?
Yep, yep. I had them all.
You know what I mean by that.
Yep. Well, they have 2 more coming, a girl and a boy.
All righty then.
Yeah. Their father's a coach on the sidelines. Played at Indiana State.
And Boxall takes his position under center and hands it off to Hughes. He's through the line of scrimmage and has the first down. Good push that time by the Hornets.
Tackled by Dylan Lindau. Tackled by Dylan Lindau.
First and goal, ball on the 9-yard line. Pick up a 5 yards on that run, Chris, for the first down. That's going to take a great effort to put the Michael Rainier.
And here's Mrs. Bell.
And Boxall back. He's looking. Pass to the end zone is complete for a touchdown. Making the catch for Preble is Nathan Prevost, and he is their leading receiver. You're going to see it again. Nice catch. Actually, not too bad a coverage that time by North. Prevost is 6'2", 220. He's a load out there. Getting set to attempt the extra point is Austin Lasse. Good snap and set. The kick is through.
To Oosberg.
To Oosberg. With 3:20 left in the first quarter, Preble on top, 7-0.
I am a Packer fan.
And we're Packers fans.
Hi, I'm David Collins, superintendent of the Wisconsin State Patrol. Packers fans are the best fans in football.
We are the ultimate team players.
The ultimate team player. Be the ultimate team player. Always have a designated driver.
Always have a
designated driver.
Live responsibly.
Packer fans.
Don't let fans drive drunk.
Responsibility has its rewards.
Go Packers!
Go Packers!
Go Packers!
Back at Urban Field getting ready for the kickoff after the touchdown by Preble. They marched 81 yards in 7 plays. Scoring play was a 9-yard pass, Van Boxel to Prevost. North caught a break early in the quarter when Preble fumbled a punt, but they couldn't take advantage of it. This kick is off.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah. I know the ball could have bounced off his shoulder pad and went into the end zone. They could have got it back out to the 20, but
watch
it didn't.
Watch this. This is a doink. Right it looked off like his face mask.
Yeah.
And Lindell with
Lindell
the
picks
grab.
It up and tries to do something with it, of course.
That's our shortstop saying it.
Yeah.
Keenan, where'd they hit you? Holy, I'll tell you, the wind's tough.
Well, you got to give this for him. He kept his eye on the ball. Meyer along with Gilbert in the backfield. Meyer drops back and then tucks it under and runs it outside the 10-yard line. Picks up a yard. Not enough. It's going to be second down and 9. Yards and 7 carries for Meyer. Hughes for Preble has 60 yards and 5 carries, getting most of those on a 46-yard run. Meyer looking for the slant again. He's got his receiver.
Uh-oh, he fumbled though, Marty.
Are they going to say it's a catch or a fumble?
Everybody, no one's saying incomplete, Marty, except for
North.
Yep, Coach Sablocki here.
Making the catch that time was Josh Fritz.
Coach Sablocki better go back to him.
And they're giving North the first down. No fumble on the play, Chris.
Yeah, that's Coach Sablocki's like, incomplete. Oh, wait a minute.
Okay, ball is going to be spotted on the 21-yard line. That's not much of a gain. 10-yard gain, but we'll take it.
Down to 2 minutes.
Yeah, this has been a very quick quarter. A lot of running. Meyer tucks it under again and takes it up over the 25-yard line. Pick up a 5 on that run. Second and 5. Let's go through the offensive line for North. At center is Brandon Ware, number 70. The guards are Pat Shesho, number 66, and Dominic Andrews, 61. The tackles are Cam Karasbach, 65, and Ryan Kinney, number 72. That's your interior line for North. They're doing a pretty good job so far tonight, Chris. Got to keep it up. Hand off to Herman. He gets it up over the, probably about to the 26 or so. Not very far.
Well, Bailey Meyer talked about it in their victory against Pulaski, how they changed up some of the blocking scheme, and it You know, again, when you're a little smaller than everybody else, you know, you got to change it up a little bit.
Herman on a no gain, Chris. It's going to be third down and 5. Maybe give them 1. What would you be generous?
I'll tell you, they look like they get big yards, but the thing is they're so far back in the backfield.
Well, the thing is, it's going sideways on some of those runs, Chris. Meyer rolling. A low pass is incomplete. His receiver, Lindau, was covered, and really he had to throw the ball that way, otherwise it might have been intercepted. It's going to be fourth down in either case. North got a little something going, Chris, and then it doesn't continue.
Yeah, I probably would have kept that one on the ground there, Marty. I probably would have kept it on the ground and so you can kick with the wind, except instead of into the wind.
30 seconds left. Kick is away. High one. Return man makes the fair catch. That was Logan Gutow. Garo, pardon me. Did you see the font on this Preble lineup?
I know.
Wow, we is that small.
Yep.
By the way, we need to give a quick shout out to Brody Waynes from Preble. He was able to read this and help me with the pronunciation. Brody is out tonight, is injured. Ball deep down the middle. Hughes had it go off his hands.
That's a little surprising call, Marty.
You got to get a throw in there with the wind,
that's
Chris.
That's true. That's true. You're right. You are 100% right.
You're darn right I'm right.
You are 100% right. Absolutely, and they took a shot. Dylan Lindo peeking in the backfield, so the deep safety was out. But the way teams run on it, I don't blame Dylan on that.
Second down and 10. Ball spotted on about the 44-yard line. There's 16.7 seconds left, so don't be surprised if they throw it again.
Yep.
Fake one way, out the other side. Garrow has it, spins off a one tackler, and is finally knocked down inside the north 40. And there's still 6.8 seconds left.
That's his 25th catch on the year. And
Rebels got it on the 37-yard line, pardon me.
They're going to run it out, Marty.
And that'll be the end of the first quarter with Preble on top, 7-0.
Naturally, spending free time running through the grass, exploring streams. But times have changed. Today's indoor kids spend more than 7 hours in front of electronic media. That's why National Wildlife Federation created the Be Out There movement. Outdoor play improves kids' health, body, mind, and spirit. It helps them stay fit, enhances creativity, and could even make them better students. There's a reason they call it the Great Outdoors. Learn more at beoutthere.org.
Yeah!
Every child adopted from foster care remembers their one day. The day he first met his forever family. The day their adoption was finalized. More than 100,000 children are waiting for their one day.
My one day was happy.
Find out more at National Adoption Day.
The left end. And gets it down to the 25-yard line. He's going to be, he's got himself a first down. Hughes on a nice run. Good blocking up front. And Preble is on the move again, Chris. 12-yard pickup for Hughes.
Yep, North just cannot stop the run.
Preble had 73 yards on 7 rushes. And that was their total offense. They were 0 for 2 passing. actually one. They did complete one pass. I didn't get that yardage down in that quarter. Figure that out. Garol made that catch. 6 and 13 is 19-yard pickup.
Well, North plays next Saturday, Marty, at Manitowoc.
Yeah, homecoming for them, I believe.
Yep, and then Manitowoc goes to South, so Manitowoc finishes with both Sheboygan schools.
Inside hand. I know a fake hand from Ben Boxall keeps it, and he's around. He's going to go into the end zone untouched. Had North totally fooled on that play. Took it from 19 yards out for a score. Ben Boxall on the touchdown run. And too easy, Chris, way too easy.
And Boxall, also a senior.
Wow. Just too easy, Chris. The run defense has just been, it's just been befuddling for North. Good snap. And the kick is wide left with 10:54 left until halftime. Preble on top, 13 to nothing.
Hi, I'm Mia Hamm. As a professional soccer player, I know how rewarding sports can be and how quickly injuries happen. So I've teamed up with the American Association of Orthodontists to ask athletes to play it safe. With my years of training, I know what it takes to become an expert, and orthodontists do too. They're the experts who help people obtain healthy, beautiful smiles. Wear mouth guards, face masks, and helmets to prevent injuries. Keep smiling, and visit braces.org.
Get us. We're back here at Urban Field. Just totaling up that first quarter offense. Preble had 92 yards with that 19-yard completion. North had 54 yards, 44 on the ground, Chris, and 12 carries. Yards per carry average is down. Actually is up from other games we've had, but it's not real good. Gilbert and Lindau back deep. We haven't seen Peter Green in the ball game yet. Lindau picks it up at the 15. And gets buried at the 25. Showed a little resilience on that kickoff when he missed the ball the first time, but picked it up and was able to gain some yards. Well, they've got the win now, Chris. Maybe they can start putting it up a little more often.
Well, I like Bailey running. I mean, just a little, you've seen some glimmer of hope there.
Cal Spaulding is wide to the right. Lindau is wide to the left. Green is on the sideline. Meyer dropped back, and then he was going to take it up the middle, but didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Preble is on to him that time.
Wow, that's a big, big front line again for Green Bay Preble. Preble's beaten Southwest, Manitowoc, and South. And they've lost to the big boys, Bayport, Eshwaunon, DePere. Bayport ranked number 7 in Division 1. DePere ranked number 2 in Division 2. And Green Bay Notre Dame ranked number 7 in Division 3.
This is an important game for them because they stand a good opportunity then to make the playoffs.
Yep.
Quick out. And getting knocked down right away was Clayton Bell.
Well, they finished.
Or no, that was Spaulding. Pardon me.
They finished with Notre Dame and Pulaski, and you would think that they could beat Pulaski. Manitowoc is the other team in the league that only has just one victory.
No gain on that pass completion.
South, Pulaski, Manitowoc, and North all have one win.
They're not going to make the playoffs.
Yep, those four are not going to.
Meyer on a third down and 11, looking down the field, trying to get by the first wave of tacklers. He does, but then Preble does a good job of gang tackling at the 28-yard line, so it's going to be a four-yard pickup, and it'll be fourth down for North again.
This will be the third punt for North.
Ball is spotted at the 29. It's going to be fourth and six. Two return men back now for Preble.
Look out.
Vander Plas is one of them. Ball is out of bounds. I don't even think it got to the 50-yard line, Chris.
It didn't.
It's being marked at the 47-yard line on North's side of the field. Again, Preble with a great rush and forcing a quick kick.
Yep, almost blocked.
They must have seen something on the tapes, Chris. Picking the right spot to come in.
Last week, Preble defeated South 35-2.
Van Boxel at quarterback. A little swing pass to the running back, Rainier, and he gets pretty good yardage. He's going to be very close to the first down. They're going to give him just short of the first down. We'll give him 9 yards on the reception. It'll be second down and one. Van Boxel takes the snap, inside hand. No, he fakes the handoff again. Missing the tackle out there was Cameron Bell. He had a shot at him behind the line of scrimmage, but couldn't hold on. And Van Boxel, again, with the good faking in the backfield, got it for a first down. Ball is spotted on the 34-yard line.
Yeah, it looked like he used a little stiff arm or something, Marty, to shake away Bell.
Yeah, they do that once in a while. Rainier in the backfield. Another missed tackle in the backfield. Come on, guys. Rainier on a good carry. He's got the first down. You know, they've gotten through, Chris. You got to wrap him up. Another good run by that young man. Ball spotted on the just outside the 20. Call it the 21. A 13-yard pickup. Hughes in the backfield now. Chris, he's a load. Hand off to him. He
there
gets hit right at the line of scrimmage and pulled down, actually behind the line of scrimmage. He's going to lose a yard. There we go, boys. Good wrap up that time.
I think Levin made that stop.
I was going to say, we got to get the number of that kid. Get his name on the air. Hughes in the backfield with Van Boxel. They've got wide receivers, two to the left, two to the right. Throwing against the wind, Van Boxel looking. Now he's going to run with it. And hanging on for dear life and making the tackle was Jacob Sheshaw. But he does get the ball down to the 15-yard line to pick up a 7. Well, I tell you, once Van Boxel hit that touchdown run, he hasn't been shy to tuck it under and run with it. Finding out how much fun it is. Fake handoff again, and getting it down near the 10-yard line and close to a first down.
Cecil there with a nice contain, forced him in the middle, but
it's going to be fourth down, Chris.
Still got a couple chunks of yards. It's going to be fourth and a yard.
Can they do it?
Preble calls timeout, Marty. It's hard to believe this. There's only 2 weeks left.
I know. Well, you know what makes it a little shorter for us, the TV guys, is we missed the first 2 weeks.
Well, I think we on one, off one, on or something. Yeah,
and then we had a week where we didn't do one because it was everybody was out of town.
We just missed the first week, and then we had South at Notre Dame. And but still, I mean, it's October 16th, your season's.
That's right. We missed over. The first week.
And I say it once, I say it 100 times that, you know, you bust your hump in the weight room for, you know, 12 months out of the year, and you play 9 Fridays.
Yeah.
And it's just really goes fast.
But on the flip side, if you are an athlete and are out for other sports, that weightlifting is good for those other activities, too. It isn't something that just,
And then
you know, is good for football.
And plan, and, you know, the coaches spend all this time prepping, and, wow, it just seems like 9 Friday nights goes fast.
Wide to the right is Garreau. He's their leading receiver, has a touchdown pass tonight. But it is 4th and 1. Pitch out to Hughes, bounces to the outside. He's got the first down and then some, and gets dragged down inside the 5-yard line. That was a pretty good run. It's going to be 1st and 10 for first and goal for the Hornets. You know, spotted on about the 3-yard line. That was a 7-yard run. Quick snap, getting in the backfield and missing a tackle. And then going into the end zone was Hughes. He was hit in the backfield, but the stop couldn't be made, and he got it in. So Hughes with another score, with a score. From 3 yards out, it's now 19-0. Let's see if Preble continues to try to kick the extra point if they try to get 2.
I think they'll go for 2 with the wind, Marty. Or, I mean,
against the wind, yeah.
Against the wind, yeah, that's what I meant.
Hughes a lone setback. And they throw it anyway, and a great catch made over there for the 2 points by Nathan Prevost. 2-pointer.
Watch this, Marty. There is no blue shirts
around him. Really?
Dylan Lindell's like, who's got all those guys?
Well, wow. We got a 3-yard run and then a 2-point conversion. Makes it now 21-0 Preble, and we still have 5:26 left in the half. Now, Bill Horst said it was senior night tonight.
Yep, and homecoming.
I was going to say, I thought it was homecoming. Also.
Yep. Yeah, it is homecoming tonight. They had senior night on the 25th, but they introduced the seniors because it's their last
home game. Okay.
Which is, like I said, October 2nd. And I've been watching ESPN or NFL Network had this thing on football in Alaska, these two teams, and how cold it is up there. It's they talk about Barrow, Alaska. It's quite interesting.
Did they mention, because I heard this about athletics in high schools up in Alaska, that a lot of their games, they travel by plane.
Oh, I don't know. But it was interesting to watch it. Barrow played Juno something the other day.
Gilbert picks it up at about the 6, and he just gets stopped. Has no, very little ability, Chris, to take a tackler and move him forward. Once he gets hit, he's pretty much stopped.
And again, a little trouble with the handling the rock.
Exactly, yeah.
Which
that makes it even tougher. Ball is going to be spotted on the 17-yard line. Be 1st and 10 North. They're down 21-0.
I see the foundation was here tonight, Marty.
Yeah,
trying to hit me up for another ticket. I already
Yeah,
got
you should have bought 5 more. Spend your money. Ran a lot. I'd buy your sodas all season. Pass is incomplete, intended for Lindau, it looked like.
Or is it intercepted? Nope, they're going to call an interception.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I think.
Let's see if we get the number of the kid who made. Oh, yeah, he cut right in front of the receiver. We didn't get the kid's name, unfortunately. But it is first and 10, Preble with an opportunity to score again.
It was Ethan Vandenplas, number 13, Marty. Okay. That's the ninth interception for Bailey.
Yeah, that's a lot. North threw into the backfield,
oh
but
my.
They missed Hughes, and he's going to take it to the house. Another score. Darion Hughes with another touchdown, Chris, from 25 yards out. He's having a big half. And with that score right there, I'd have to say, Chris, the route is on. It's just, they just...
Well, they're just undersized, Marty. You just get, every team you play, you get blown at the line of scrimmage. You know, every once in a while, like you said, you see opportunities to make plays, and they don't happen. But over the course of a ball game, I mean, they give up 60, 70, 80 pounds a guy.
Let's say his kick is true that time. With 5:05 left in the first half, it's 28 to nothing.
Was a combat medic who was injured in Iraq. When I met Ian, I knew he had to help him get his housing grant, an auto grant, and every benefit to live as normal a life as possible. And we did.
PVA has helped hundreds of thousands of veterans get the care and benefits they've earned.
My name is Jason Stevenson, and I work for Paralyzed Veterans of America.
Paralyzed Veterans of America, changing lives, building futures.
Sheboygan North trotting out on the field to receive this kickoff. Chris, you mentioned earlier about they've got a lot of kickoff returns this year.
They do. They lead. It's not even funny when you look on the conference stats. I mean, they got just, you're talking over 10 a person more than, you know, who's ever got the third most.
Lindahl and Bell back deep. Lassay had one in the end zone to start the game, but that was with the wind. A squib kick, takes a nice bounce. Oh, run with the ball, man. Have some fun. Weren't you watching the broadcast Saturday morning? I told you what to do. God, it's just like having a kid in class. They don't listen either. Come on, Peyton. Run with the ball.
Yeah, what do you got to lose?
Exactly. Are you going to fumble it and all of a sudden they're going to take the lead on you? Jeez. Gain some yardage. Try to put your team in a better spot. Whoop.
Cheating.
Yeah, that's a major cheat. By the way, that may have been our first flag.
I think.
All half. I think it has been. I don't have any P's written down anywhere on my sheet. That's a PP, penalty on Preble. First and 5 for North. Ball on the 35 now. Bailey Meyer at the controls again. Krebsbach on the pull. Nobody there to block. Pat Sheschel, pardon me. Meyer picks up maybe a yard or two, not much. It's going to be second down and 4. Geez, you only got to get 5 guys. Come on. Give him 2 yards on the play. A different back there, Chris. Unless that's Herman. It is. Herman trying to bounce it to the outside. He gets hit and driven back. You're right about that Preble defense. They're very strong up front.
Yeah, I mentioned, you know, when you're talking 3 teams ranked and Preble is not, it's just 300 into, excuse me, 300, 500, 3-3 in league, but they are 3rd in the league in defense. And
very close to the top, too. I mean, the yardage between the top three are not that great.
3:35 and counting before halftime, but it is third down and five for North. That five-yard penalty didn't help enough.
Oh, boy.
Picked off, making the good read, and running it back before getting tackled was Prebles. Carter Kudick.
Well, he read that all the way, Marty.
Yeah. Boy, oh boy. We're going to have a running clock to start the second half, Chris. Ball's on the four. Rainier behind the blocking back, Ponce. Look at Ponce. He'll take it to the ball. Well, he actually got the ball. Throw him a bone, right?
That's right. Give him a little love. I've sat there on the entire game on Monday night, and I didn't see John Kuhn touch the ball once. As a matter of fact, I don't think he's touched the ball all season.
Not even a pass catch, huh?
I don't remember. I might be wrong with that.
Yeah, I know he hasn't gotten the ball often. And Boxall on a slant pass.
That's not a good play call.
Well, I thought it could have been interference, but it's okay. Pass incomplete.
Yep. They should just be pounding it.
It's going to be third and goal. Ball still on the four-yard line. Actually, they got it at the six. Six-yard line. Rainier, the deep back. The only back. Pitch out to him, trying to bounce it. Good.
Uh-oh.
A good penetration by North, but then Rainier goes the other way, and he gets near the end zone, and he is in. Just got over the top of Hayden Herman and scored. Watch this. Good penetration by Weston Yurick and made him go back the other direction, and he did fall into the end zone. That was a good call by the official. It was about 50 yards of running for 6 yards.
What a play by Rainier there to decide to come back.
Yeah. Weston Yurick, good penetration. Lassay his kick is through. 2:37 left until halftime. It's now 35-0. 28 points in the quarter, Chris.
Can't see me on TV, but I'm shaking my head. I don't know what to say, and I don't know what the coaches are going to say.
They finished the quarter, first quarter, 7-0. I mean, they didn't play very good in terms of offense or defense, but they're still in the game.
Yep. And they actually, you know, with the help of the fumble, they had moved the ball a little bit. And then they gave up the ball with 22 seconds left. And then Ben Boxall had that 19-yard run. And since then, it's like...
it hasn't been fun for us either.
Nope. And I think they lost some of the... Hey.
Is it windy out there? We don't count down here. Same cast of characters back deep for North, and the same character doing the kicking for the Hornets. I'll pick it up and run with it, Spalding. Oh! Oh, there's a big scramble. Nobody for North could pick the ball up, and Preble is saying, we've got it. And they do. Oh, my. That ball was just squirting all over the place, Chris. I mean, it squirted away from the first guy about almost 4 or 5 yards. Unbelievable.
You know, and the Preble guys are excited, but those kickoff guys, you know, most of those guys probably aren't starters. Well, that's a big thrill for them. They don't care what the score is.
Exactly. You're right. Fumble lost. And Boxall still at quarterback. Hughes the deep back. Fumble, picks it up, gives it to Hughes. And that just allowed North enough time to fight off the blocks and make Hughes stopped after only a 1 or 2 yard gain. Give him one. He's second down and 9.
And the wind is a howling.
Yep, the Hawk.
2:09 left in quarter number 2.
And Boxall handoff to Hughes, trying to bounce it off the left end. And we get a flag. It looks like it's going to go against Preble for holding. And that might have gone, might be against our Ponce, the blocking back. I don't know if we get a replay on that. Take a look at 32, see if he was the guy doing the holding. You're going to see the official call the penalty.
Well, next week we go to Kohler High School and watch Lutheran Christian and Kohler squad
KLC
play Howard's Grove.
Second down and 18. Ball is spotted on the 38. Fakes one way, comes back the other. He's got Groh. Avoids one tackler, and then he's finally pushed out of bounds near the 30.
Watch this here. Fake to the left, throw back to the right. Nice kick out block.
All righty, it's going to be third down and about 10 or 11. And Boxall back, looking. Stiff arms one tackler and goes deep down the sideline, but way over the head of his intended receiver. It's going to be fourth down. What do you do here, Chris?
I would punt.
Are you serious?
Yes.
You're at the 31-yard line.
I'd punt.
North hasn't done anything with it.
That's why I'd punt.
Yeah, but you only got a minute 27
left.
Yeah,
that's why.
It's not like they're going to march the field. Yeah. And Boxall looking down, fires a pass that's over the head of the intended receiver. We had timeout North just before the snap. Oops. Okay. North has one timeout left, I believe. In the quarter, Preble is two completions and 5 attempts. Groh had an 11-yard reception, and Rainier had a 9-yard reception earlier. They've not passed the ball much tonight. They only attempted 2 in the first quarter. Fourth down and 11. Oh, Van Boxall taking it.
Ooh, short.
He gets crushed inside the 25, but he is short. Chris called it. 1:20 left. North will take over on downs. Yahoo. Ball's going to be spotted, I believe, at the 23-yard line. First and 10 for North. They trail it 35-0, unless they can put some points on the board prior to the half. It's going to be a running clock to start the second half. deep down the sideline. Lindau can't quite catch up to it. Meyer really wing that one down there, Chris.
You know, Bailey's a pretty good quarterback, Marty.
Yeah, strong arm. Tell you how to get that boy out for baseball.
Like to see him on a...
He doesn't need to be running around a track.
I'd like to see what he could do with a big front line. And
well, you won't find it here.
No, he's a senior. Undersized for the line.
All right, second down and 10. Ball spotted on the 23. 1:14 left. Meyer tucks it under and picks up maybe 2 or 3 yards. Not much, not enough. It's going to be third down. Give him 3 yards on the play. The North rolled up 54 yards in the first quarter. They don't have that this quarter, not even close.
We're under 50 seconds, Marty.
Yeah, clock is running.
And North is not, like, hustling to get the play in here.
Maybe use that last time out if they get a first down. Meyer rolling right, throwing on the run, threw it behind Cal Spaulding. Pass is incomplete. It's going to be fourth down and 7. I suppose you got to punt it, eh? Of course, 27.3 seconds left. This would be an interesting situation, Chris. Go for it on fourth down. Let's say you don't get it. So ball turns over on downs. There's about 20 seconds left. Probably going to try and score. Are they going
to? No, they're not to peer.
Okay. Ooh.
Oh, that was brutal last week.
Wow.
40 to 7.
Wow-wee, Chris. I hope this tape doesn't get
up to Green
Bay. They're
on the other 25-yard line when they.
Ooh, there was a penalty. Running into Bailey Meyer, the punter, and Garreau gets tackled. And 17.3 seconds left. That should be enough for the first down. Unless they mark it from the spot of the foul. It's 15 yards and you're still a couple of yards short. Aye, aye, aye.
Well, last week, Preble, they were up 40 to 7 on their own 25 with 54 seconds left and they're attacking down the field. And they called timeout at midfield with a second left.
I'm not sure if we talked about this last week, but I know I heard it over the course of a few days that once you are in that running clock situation, that's it. It doesn't stop anymore.
Correct.
Are they going to give him the first down? Yes. Penalty on the punt. Penalty on Preble. It's going to be first and 10 for the Raiders. Ball is going to be spotted on the 41-yard line. They got a chance here, Chris. 17.3 seconds left. I was kind of thinking maybe, you know, Peter Green did something, sit him out the first quarter, you know, let him in. It'll be interesting to see if he gets in the second half or if this is a full game situation, whatever it is. I mean, maybe he got hurt. We don't know. Meyer with a nice run gets it down to the Preble 41. That's an 18-yard pickup right there. First and 10.
Looks to me like North's going to use one of their timeouts.
I believe that is the last. If they use it, it's their last one.
No, they had two. They had two, and it's down to one. So
really? It's too cold. We got some North fans wanting to come in the booth and join us. Suck it up, man. It's not that cold. It's not that cold.
He was a left-handed pitcher for us.
All right, come on in.
Well, he decided not to finish the season. He was a freshman last year, but he did a nice job for us.
Really? Yep. What's that kid's name? Whitey Ford? Mark Burley. Clayton Kershaw.
Speaking of that, your Cubs are in the playoffs, which will be
It's pretty awesome.
Fun to see.
You know who's really excited? Our Horizons.
Be a fun week next, what, Tuesday night they probably play?
Look at the four defensive backs back on the inside the five-yard line.
Good play. I love that. I absolutely love that.
Clock running. Quick out. It's incomplete to Lindau.
Yep. I wish more teams did that. I always say just put your guys back and first, or maybe they've been watching some of our TV things, and that's what I would do too. That way you can't score. I wish more teams would do that. I wish more NFL teams would do that.
7.4 seconds left.
You just drop your linebackers about, you know, 15, 20 yards back, and then
Meyer running the left-end sweep. Boom, he gets leveled at the 35. I hope he's not hurt, Chris. He's not getting up real quick. And that is the half. Hopefully, Bailey's up walking off the field, but he took a hard hit that time. Watch that right there. All right, well, we're at halftime. Preble on top, 35-0.
This video was submitted by a student through the Teens Drive Smart program. For more information on teen safety, visit teensdrivesmart.com.
Don't allow your weight to threaten your health or control your future. Excess weight or obesity can cause emotional and physical health risks. But you can take control. The Your Weight Matters campaign offers free resources and tips to help you.
Last play of the half. North got a timeout with 1 second left. Meyer's going to try and hit a long field goal, but it's short, and now we are at halftime. Meyer got hit hard on that end run, but was able to bounce up, and North got the timeout in time. They attempted a field goal trying to avoid that 35-point spread. We're not able to do it, however. We will play the entire second half with a running clock, but we are at halftime. Preble on top, 35-0.
Because sometimes, even the rescuers need to be rescued. The Coast Guard Foundation. Find out how you can help at rescuetherescuers.org.
This little chick has hearing loss. It can be lonely, sad, and often accompanied by ringing in the ears or even loss of balance. But there's good news, because birds have an almost magical way of regenerating their inner ear cells to restore their own hearing, so they can live a happy, chirpy lifestyle. Imagine if science could achieve the same miracle with people. Well, at Hearing Health Foundation, we support research that is doing just that. Visit us at hhf.org and learn more about the cure for hearing loss in tonight.
Can't nobody stop me. I'm a hot. In the back, but I'm with me. She can't stop. Pull up in the house. Well,
Did you know that your thumbs are some of the scariest things on the planet? Every year, an average of 6,000 people lose their lives to thumbs that are used to text while driving. That means that your opposable digit is more dangerous than volcanoes, sharks, airplanes, jellyfish, tigers, lions, tornadoes, roller coasters, hippos, skydiving, spiders, and snakes. Texting while driving is more dangerous than all of those things. So why isn't it one of your biggest fears?
This video was submitted by a student through the Teens Drive Smart program. For more information on teen safety, visit teensdrivesmart.com.
Allison Pond and Becky Presley.
Heavy metal band Budgie, made popular in the U.S. by Metallica, the band would like to open its show for you with Rip Van.
Comes from the rock legend Ozzy Osbourne. With a career that has spanned 5 decades, Ozzy was one of the most influential musicians in the development of heavy metal. After being fired from Black Sabbath, Ozzy launched his solo career with one of the most recognized themes in heavy metal. Tonight, we feature our percussion and low brass sections with our rendition of Crazy Train.
Thank you.
energy and dedication goes into the study of music. Tonight's show is a culmination of nearly a decade of musical study by the students on the field and the support of many people, including the music teachers, administration, and private teachers in the area that many of our students study with. But most importantly, the support of our band parents. We would like to thank each of you for tolerating these early years when your students were first learning, to the middle years when the percussionist finally discovered the practice pad, and for your dedication and support of the bands here at North. Parents, you do so much for our bands, from attending concerts and pep bands to fundraising and baking for concerts and chaperoning trips. Your efforts and dedication are truly appreciated, and we want to thank you for all you do. At this time, we'd like the band parents in the crowd to please stand up and be recognized for their efforts. We would also like to take a moment to recognize the seniors in the band. Morgan Kohanek, Altice Martinez, Claudette Bean, Crosby Carino.
Getting out of the military, I was missing this camaraderie.
It's frustrating when you try and talk to people that don't understand.
I still had the anger, I still had the addictions, but we didn't talk about that.
Came to a point where it's like, okay, I really need to talk to somebody about this.
Family more or less encouraged me, you know, go to the VA.
It's okay to go get help. It's okay to talk to people, because it takes true strength to ask for help.
Hear veterans' real stories of strength and recovery at maketheconnection.net.
In Wisconsin, the laws are the same for bicyclists and motorists. So if you bike, ride with the traffic and obey stop signs and lights. Whether you ride a bike or drive a car, you must yield the right-of-way to pedestrians at marked and unmarked crosswalks. At intersections, always look for pedestrians before making a turn. And slow down in school zones and neighborhoods to keep our kids safe. Share and be aware. We're all responsible.
Ready to wrap up halftime. We've got some statistics for you. Preble finished the half with 225 yards, 186 of those on the ground. Their leading rusher was Darion Hughes, 12 carries and 113 yards. North had 86 yards for the half, and Chris is going to talk a little bit about that, but Meyer had a tough first half at quarterback, only completing 2 of 9 passes with 2 interceptions. He was the leading rusher, however, with 71 yards in 14 carries. Hughes, I had mentioned, had a big half with 113 yards. He also scored 2 touchdowns. Chris?
Well, I thought... We talked a little bit at the break, you know, how North started. They looked like they were all right. They had 37 of their 86 yards on that first drive. Now, they also got added 20 yards of a muff punt there. But after that, things just kind of went downhill. And I think you made a great point. At the end of the first quarter, things were really well. But the second quarter was just dominated by Preble. And
28 points.
And it wasn't even that close. And we'll see what shows up here in the second half. It's going to be another quick half here at North.
Yeah, running clock, and we'd mentioned this in the first half. Once the running clock is instituted, it stays running. You don't get below 35 and then all of a sudden do the regular clock. It doesn't work that way. Meyer's kick carries down to inside the 5. And Grau, on the return, gets it up to near the 25-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for Preble. And we are off.
Yeah, it's running clock except for scores. There you see their replay there. It'll be interesting to see what Preble comes out with here. It looks like they're going to still go with Van Boxel here.
Yeah, they got the big up-back is in there too, Carlos Ponce. The deep-back, it looks like Hughes.
Sure, they'll play one series and be done, Marty.
Yeah, Darion Hughes, he gets the handoff, pounds it up the middle. gets it up over the 25, but not much more. Pretty good defensive stop that time by the Raiders. Second down. Preble looked awfully good in that second quarter, scoring four touchdowns. And Boxall on a quarterback sneak. It looked a little suspicious because the lone back there was right only a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage. It's going to be third down and one. Ball at the 34-yard line. Hughes and Ponce in the backfield. Hughes gets it right up the middle. He's through the line of scrimmage. Tries to bounce it outside and gets it up over the 45-yard line. A very nice run that time by Darion Hughes.
Look at this. The hole's created and shoots through there. And it's, you know, you're into the second and third level of defenders of North before he even gets touched.
He's going to have a big game rushing tonight. Up over 120 yards.
Yep. Wide out. Halftime, he had 119. Yep, he's going to be another back close to 200 yards.
First and 10, Van Boxall right up the middle. Took the snap from center and went right up the middle and gained 10 yards. Watch this.
Yeah, I was going to say, watch this. Got the run blitz, so let's just follow your center.
Well, they've been... They must have seen something to notice that you could get that kind of yardage. Defensive line must be doing some stunting. Ponce,
give me the ball.
Gets it down to the 35.
Yerk and Lindau on a tackle.
It's going to be second down and three. 7 yard pickup. Inside handoff to Ponce again. He's not going down yet. Finally he goes down, but I believe he's got the first down. Got it down to the 31 yard line.
237-pound fullback.
Yeah, he's a load. Probably the first and 10 ball spotted on the 31.
Down to 7:50 left, running clock.
And Boxall still at quarterback, hands it off to Hughes.
There's a good tackle.
Yep. Hanging on that time for North was L.J. Werner making the tackle. He's one of those kids, Chris, that had his number changed. Second down and nine.
Yeah, he's playing defensive end, 5'10", 200, but I don't know. Maybe in gear.
Hughes off a nice block by Ponce, gets it down inside the 25. Watch the block by 32 right there. Boom.
Yep.
Knocks the defender off and allows his back to cut it up inside. It's going to be third down. Hughes still in the backfield. We haven't seen Rainier yet. And
Lindau.
Lindau on the tackle, but on what back in there in the backfield was, we don't have a name for number six. Unless that was Yerick, number eight. But Hughes on the carry. And he gets the first down.
Yep, that was Yerk. Lindau with the big stuff there.
Check that. It's fourth down and one.
Yep.
Ball spotted on the 21.
Oh, what a play by Bailey Meyer.
All righty. Right through. Made the stop for a loss. Good job, Bailey. Watch this.
Woo!
Not this time. Chris, I'll give you a story from the 60s. Back when I was in high school, our quarterback, Mike Krieger, he was a good one, was leading scorer in the conference, football. Sellinger and I did all the work. He got the glory. Get it down to the one, he'd take it in. Anyway, he also played both ways. And he was quite an athlete. Could dunk a basketball. Went about 6'1", 6'2". But he was a second or first team all-conference player. I think he was close to maybe like being All-State honorable mention. But there was a kid, quarterback, going both ways. So Meyer is that kind of, I don't know if he's that kind of athlete, but for this team, he's that kind of talent. Lindau from short, throwing it deep to Green. He's got it. He's going to go for the touchdown, Sheboygan North, 75 yards.
And a flag down, Marty.
Oh, no. What happened? Well, we couldn't see. It was out of our camera angle, but anyway, a great throw and catch. It wasn't really from short, by the way. It was from the backfield. But Lindau with a good toss, and they're going to call it back? Oh, man, come on, guys.
What'd they call?
Yeah, really. Holding North?
No. What'd they call? It's still a spot foul, Martin. But what'd they call?
Holding on North. He called holding on North. They're going to spot the ball on the 22.
No, unsportsmanlike for what? I wonder what that was about.
So pass goes to Green. Instead of being 75 yards, 65, 55, 53 yards. Oof. 53-yard completion.
Bailey Meyer back in at quarterback.
But he didn't carry the ball that time.
Dylan did, yep.
You sure? Dylan, Lindau.
Yeah, Lindau.
Okay. You said Bailey.
Yeah, Bailey back in the game right now.
Oh, now. Okay. All right. We'll give you that. Second down and 9. Ball spotted on the 22. Bailey Meyer keeps it, cuts it back, gets down near the 10-yard line. It's going to be close to a first down. He does have the first down. Watch this cut back. Right there and then there. First and 10 North, ball spotted on the 12. It's a 10-yard pickup for Bailey. Trotting off the field for North is Josh Fritz. Josh had a catch back in the first half. Meyer, the lone setback, takes the direct snap. Tries to cut it up, but the defense of Preble got penetration and held him to little or no gain. Actually, probably lost a half a yard. It's going to be second down. We'll call it 10. A lot of running, Chris. He trots off the field to get the play, and then he trots back on and
yep.
Then he tries to run north and south, and then it's east and west, and then north and south again. I mean, that's...
And you're playing both ways a lot of time.
Haven't they invented hand signals yet?
Or send in a back?
Yeah, really. Bailey looking. Ball is almost intercepted, making a great break on the ball for Preble was Apias, Anthony Apias. Watch this cut in front of the receiver.
Three defenders there, Marty.
That was a good play. I don't know, is it easier for you to see when it's that way? Me too. It's going to be third down and 10. North was an 145 and counting here in the quarter. It's obviously been a very quick quarter with the running clock.
Getting close to delay, Marty. Getting close to a delay. Getting close to a delay. Oh, gosh.
That's the delay. I thought the guy in the white hat that's going to call the delay again. Oh, no, North called a timeout to prevent the...
Flag went up, though.
Yeah, flag came out of the pocket. You're right. But they're going to give North the timeout. Good decision there. Next week, Chris mentioned this back in the first half. We'll mention it in the second half. We are going to be out at Kohler when KLC plays Howard's Grove. And last year when we went out there, Chris, they played Howard's Grove and beat them. And there was a nice article in this morning's paper about the tough schedule Howard's Grove's football team has had. And the essence of the article was they had the really hard games early on in the season and things lighten up a little bit towards the end. Hopefully that's not the case for them next Friday. We want to see a win.
Both teams fighting for the playoffs, Marty.
Yeah. After tonight's game, we, WSCS Sports football season, are going to be 2-3 on the year.
We finish up at South against Manitowoc.
Yeah, South. Manitowoc will be at South. We'll cover that game. They have a good chance of winning there. Manitowoc is not that tough. Meyer looking, going on the out pattern to Green, and the pass is, they're going to throw a flag. Wow. I don't know if I like that call, Chris. I'd have just done a no call, actually. Oh, you never look for the ball. That was a good call.
Easy call, yep.
Yep. Vander Plas forgot to look for the ball. It's going to be a penalty on Preble, pass interference. It should be another. Are you going to give him a first down on that then? Clock running, 50 seconds left. Still third down. Well, now they're marking it off. I'll tell you, they're taking their time, Chris. That running clock. No urgency whatsoever. Okay, it's going to be first down. First and goal.
They still got third down. That shouldn't be.
Yeah.
So you can pass it. Never mind. I'm not even going to talk about it.
Billy Meyer keeps it. Gets dragged down inside the five. Not going to be enough, and that'll be the last play of the quarter.
Simple moments are what make every day count.
If I ride, I will know the way the trees smell after the rain. I will grow a heart so strong that hospitals will take Tuesdays off. If I ride, road rage will turn into laughter, and oil tankers will haul chocolate milk. And I won't be a boy or a girl. I will just be a rider.
Back at North High School, getting ready to start fourth quarter action. The score remains Preble 35, North nothing. No scoring in that third quarter. There were only two possessions. Preble kept it for 10 plays before they were stopped. And then North got it and ran off 2, 4, 6, 7. And that was the quarter. Yeah. Running clock goes fast.
6 minute, 14 second drive for Preble, which, of course, with the running clock, it doesn't stop on first downs. Went quite quickly, and now we're set here with...
It's fourth down and about 3 yards to go. Short three, long two, somewhere in that neighborhood. North thought they had a touchdown. It was a 75-yard bomb, Lindau to a Green, but there was holding. The ball was spotted at the 22. Ball is tipped. And
actually,
incomplete.
It was unsportsmanlike, Marty, not a holding.
Okay. Well, you know what, though? The guy in the white hat went like this on both sides. I didn't, you know, there may have been that. I didn't see it, but yeah. It doesn't matter. North didn't score, and they were stopped on an incomplete pass, and it's bad news.
Turnover and downs here. Well, Marty, I had some sixth-grade girls that said they wanted their names on TV, so I had to explain basically how do they pay for TV today, and none of them could figure out, and I said, well, it's basically by you purchasing items, and that becomes commercials. So I did ask for
sodas.
So I asked for a fee.
Did they pay up?
They didn't pay up. They said, well, a fee. I said, yeah, if you want advertisements, you got to pay for it.
Yeah, really?
But Cordelia, Louisa, and Haley, they all want their names on TV.
Rainier on the carry. It's going to be second down and four, five. Pick up a five on the play.
Yeah, the Damcott twin girls. They were taping the game. They've watched before.
Well, good for them.
Yeah, Emma Quashus watches too.
You mentioned that you've talked to a number of people that do watch the games.
Especially live. They've been watching it. It's a nice opportunity for people to not have to come out in the 35-degree wind chill. We've had rain this year and fog. Maybe next week it'll be a nice day over at Kohler.
That was a 10-yard pickup by Van Boxel. He's still in there, Chris. A little surprised at that.
Yep, and now but we got Rainier with...
He doesn't, you know, he hasn't played much quarterback all year, so in a way I can see why you keep him in there. Otherwise, you're down to your third-string quarterback. Of course, you might be that if this kid gets hurt. Ponce. And whoever he was blocking, there was some good hitting out there. I didn't catch who carried the ball. Second down and nine. Make it second and 11. Ball on the 19. Rainier, the deep back, Ponce, the up back. It's been a lot of running by the Hornets here. Rainier breaks one tackle, breaks another. He's on his feet, trying to cut it back. And I'll tell you, I'm not even sure you can call it bad tackling because I don't even know what that is out there. I don't know what that is. Let's tug on their shirt. First and 10, Green Bay. Ball spotted on the north, 45.
Preble will have a nice baseball team this year in the spring, Marty. They might just be the favorites. To deep throw in Bayport, not saying that that's going to be an easy task.
How are the Raiders going to be?
We'll be okay, better. Going to be a lot of kids back. Which is always a good thing.
Yeah, really.
Just because you're older doesn't mean you're better. They got a little work to do, but we'll be all right.
Rainier bouncing. Picks up 8 yards there. He's going to wind up having a pretty nice night too, Chris, if he keeps grabbing chunks of yardage. He had a 36-yarder just before. Ponce up back. He's done a great job blocking tonight. You know, he gets a bone again. but not going very far. They whistle him down, even though he really wasn't down, but they stopped the play. 7:25 left.
Big 54, Nathan Heitzman, just a sophomore on the stop there. 5'11", 200-pounder.
It's going to be third down and three. Ponce actually lost a yard on that, Chris.
Well, Ponce needs to know the play call.
Got a new quarterback in there, it looks like.
Yep.
Of course, he's not on our roster, number 10. New running back, too. That kid is quick. Wow. Look at him bounce to the outside. He ran into his own guy. Is he in, though?
Short.
Just short. He ran into his own guy right at the end.
Jesse Cantu.
Cantu, yeah. Watch this. He runs into his own guy. Oh, but it's a hold. It's all coming back. Jesse, nice run, kiddo. It happens. What can I say? Taking him way back. Penalty on Preble. It's going to be, it's going to remain third down, but the ball has moved all the way back to the 49-yard line of Preble. That makes it about 15 yards for a first down. Third and 15. Clock running. 5:50 left.
This game will be over in about 6 minutes, Marty. More Hankies on the field.
Oh, man.
Well, this just keeps the clock running, Marty.
Right. Yeah. Nobody gets hurt.
Notice there was no penalties when the game was still close. Now, as this takes off time, everything's flying. Got some new kids in there, too. So.
Oh, right. That makes a huge difference. You're right. Absolutely. Our last trip over here to North this year. At least until basketball starts.
Davis Larson going to be a senior, huh?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Really? Seems like he was just a freshman.
Yep.
Rainier gets it up to the 45. Give him a whole one-yard pickup on that play.
Very special young man, too, Davis. I say during the basketball season, too, I love to have a whole team full of Davis Larsons with his worth ethic and his class on and off the field.
And it's not second class either.
Nope.
Lindau going back, the lone return man for North on this punt. Lassay.
He's the leading punter in the league.
No, it wasn't Lassay. It was Cantu, I believe. Number 20? No, 26. That is Julian Charles on the punt.
That's not Lassay, leading punter in the league.
He didn't look like the leading punter in the league. He was kicking with the wind, too. Let's see where they're going to spot that ball. It's going to be first and 10 North. Going to call it the 36.
You know, and I think they scheduled the fifth quarter here. They anticipated the weather being a little nicer.
Yeah, really?
We will be packing up.
Yep, they're going to be playing for us, Chris. The TV crew. Meyer tucks it under. Gets it out to the 47-yard line. Pickup of about 11 yards. First and 10 North. That was the first offensive play of the quarter, Chris, for the Raiders. Check that, the second. The first one was the incomplete pass on fourth down. Probably looking like they're going to blitz, but they don't. On the carry that time for North was Jamil Amerson. Armisen. He's going to be second down. He picked up 5 yards on that run. Nice little run there. Second down. Handoff. Hayden Herman gets it inside the 40. Nice run for him.
It'll be
first and 10 for North.
2 minutes left in the game.
Haven't been able to say that often, Bill Horsch. First down Raiders. Haven't had too many of those.
Well, I said it once, I'll say it again, Marty. I'll wait till after this play.
Amason, the deep back. Quick pitch out to Green. Slips by one tackler before he's dragged down. Picks up about 6.
I give all these young men a lot of credit for sticking with it. You know, they go through the halls, and I'm sure they hear you guys aren't very good and all these stuff. And, you know, you got to play it because you love it, you know. And sometimes the results always don't turn out the way you want it. But, you know, there are memories like you have. And
oh, I remember. Yeah. I can remember those days. My first year, my sophomore year, we weren't very good. Last two were pretty tough.
But you still remember just playing.
Oh, you know, definitely.
With your friends
definitely.
And buddies. So it's been the case here at North for a number of years.
Herman broke loose. He cut it back and gained a lot of yardage. Watch this.
It's 2 good runs in a row for him.
Yep, cuts it back, got through the pile of players, and he might. North has a chance to score. They're down at near the 11-yard line.
Well, you have 2 timeouts, Marty. You might as well.
Yeah, they're under 35 seconds left. It's first and goal.
I'm sure they'll use one after this play.
First and 10, ball spotted on the 15.
Are you going to use a timeout Anderson. Or are you going to end it?
Arneson on the carry.
Nope.
Second down.
Last play of the game, Marty.
Ball on the 8.
Bet you they throw it to Peter Green on a little thing to the left. I think they're going to go to the flag.
Off just in time, handoff. Herman gets knocked down at about the 7, and that's the ball game. North trotting off the field. Final score again, Preble 35, North nothing. North drops to 1-6, Preble improves to 4-3. Our next game will be at Kohler when KLC hosts Howard's Grove. We didn't mention them all night, we gotta get them in there, the crew. Kerry Kautzer was our director. Richard Bartson ran the top camera, giving you that shot there. Eric Wiesman was on the field. And for my partner, Chris Wright, I'm Mike Martin saying thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you next week.